Hey, what's going on everybody? It's your bro here, and in this video I'm going to teach you guys how you can create some pretty sweet shadow effects in CSS. So let's get into it. Now there's two different kinds of shadow properties that I'm going to be discussing with you guys. They are text shadows for text and box shadows for other HTML elements. So let's begin by adding some sample text to our webpage on our HTML document. All we really need to do is just add one line here. Just writing shadow demo using h1 tags should suffice for this. So let's save, reload. Honestly, this is all we need for this demonstration. We're going to do everything else on our CSS document. So let's make a few changes before we do introduce shadows. So I'm going to target the h1 tag. I believe I'll add a border that is 1 pixel and solid. Let's add a width of 200 pixels. And maybe some padding of 25 pixels. All right, let's save this and reload the page. Okay, this should work for now. I'm happy with it. So we have two different kinds of shadows to work with. Text shadows, and I'll just set this to 0 for now, as well as box shadows. And I will also set this to 0. Now with each of these properties, there's 4 fields that we can fill in, 4 values that we can assign, and I'm going to write these as a comment. So I'm going to create a cheat sheet for you guys. So I'm going to write it within here. The first is the horizontal displacement, and you can write this in pixels. The second is the vertical displacement, also in pixels. Third is the blur effect, also in pixels. And lastly is the color. You can choose a color name, an RGB value, or a hexadecimal value. All right, now with all of these values, the same thing also applies for the box shadow. So I'm going to put our cheat sheet right underneath it, and we'll fill a few of these out for the text shadow first and then the box shadow. Let's begin with text shadows. So this first value applies to the horizontal displacement of the shadow relative to the text. And the second value is the vertical displacement of the shadow relative to the text. So if we were to set our horizontal displacement to maybe 2 or another positive number, we would have a shadow effect that is on the right-hand side of our text. If this was a negative number, this would move to the left. And the greater the magnitude, the greater the displacement would be. Like if I set this to negative 20 pixels, we would have a shadow that's very far out to the left. So you can change these depending on what sort of shadow effect you want. And the same thing applies to our vertical displacement. So a positive number would create a shadow effect downwards, and a negative number would create a shadow effect upwards. And then you can combine both of these. So maybe we'll pick 5 pixels by 5 pixels. We'll end up with a shadow that goes down and to the right, although it's a little difficult to see because the shadow is black as well as the text color. So we'll have to change that. So we can also add a blur effect. That is the third value that we can type in here. And the magnitude of the blur effect is in pixels. So we'll start with 1 pixel and see what effect this has. So there's not much of a change here with 1 pixel. Let's increase this to 2. Okay, we're getting somewhere. And then maybe 3. All right, 3's not too bad. But I think I'm going to change the horizontal and vertical displacement back to 2. And that doesn't look too bad. That's like a 3D effect, which is pretty sweet. Now with the fourth value, we can add a color. You can pick a color name, an RGB value, or a hexadecimal value. I think I'll just pick something simple like yellow. So let's save, reload, and we now have a yellow shadow effect around our text. And what we end up with is a yellow shadow effect that is displaced 2 pixels down vertically and 2 pixels to the right horizontally. Now you can actually create a glow effect if you set the horizontal as well as the vertical displacement to 0. It would actually appear as if this text was glowing, which is pretty cool too. But I'm going to change the blur effect up slightly. It's kind of like a light bulb or a neon glow of some sort. I think that's pretty sweet. And another cool thing that you can do with shadows is that you can add more than one. For example, we could add a second shadow, and I decided for this demonstration, I want to create a shadow effect that makes my text look like it's on fire. So I'm going to add a second red shadow that's slightly above the text. So what you can do if you want to add a second shadow after the first set of values, just add a comma and you can add in a whole nother set of values to add. So if I want a red shadow effect that hovers above the text, I will set our horizontal displacement to 0 pixels. For the vertical displacement, maybe negative 5 pixels. Then for a blur, 5 pixels is good. And then for a color, I will pick red. So let's save this, reload, and we now have this sweet fire effect for our text. Now let's move on to box shadows. It's a very similar process to what we had with text shadows, except a box shadow will target an HTML element. So this box shadow is going to be displaced relative to where this border is. So let's fill this in. So we need a horizontal as well as a vertical positioning for this shadow. I think I will set this first one to 10 and the second one to 10. So let's save, reload. We now have this very sharp black shadow, but we'll probably want to add a blur to make it look more natural. So I tend to like 5 pixels for my blur. All right, but it's still somewhat dark, so we can also change the color. And I think I will use a hexadecimal value this time. So if you use all sixes, so that's 6 sixes, this will be like a nice grayish dark color. And I think that's pretty sweet. So that's all the box shadow is. It adds a shadow effect around an HTML element, much like the text shadow adds a shadow effect around text. So that's the very basics of using shadows in CSS. I'm just going to add a few other changes, not related to shadows, but just a few properties I want to add to make this shadow really stand out and look really cool. So I'm just going to change the background color of our HTML element. So background-color to black. Let's see what we have so far. All right, you can really see the shadow effect now, but the text is somewhat dark, so I'm going to change the color of that. So the color of our text, we can change that to maybe white. Okay, that's pretty sweet. It's kind of like the text is so hot that it's glowing and giving off flames. But I also want to change the border color, so I'm going to say border-color black. Let's save, reload. All right, that is pretty sweet. I'm pretty happy with that. So yeah, I guess that is the basics of using text shadows as well as box shadows in CSS. If you want a copy of all this markup that we worked on today, I'll post it in the comments down below and pin it to the top. But yeah, that is how you can create basic shadows in CSS. Hey you, if you enjoyed this lesson, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.